Please get ready for a dictation of transcription number 276 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, this is a short bill and the background of this legislation is briefly as follows. The House is aware that in the autumn session of Parliament last year, an amendment was made to our law relating to patents by inserting a new provision, namely Section 23, to the Indian Patents and Designs Act 2001, with a view to empowering the controller of patents and designs to grant liberal working licenses to the interested parties in respect of patents for food, medicines, surgical or curative devices at any time after a patent has been granted on terms and conditions to be determined by him. On that occasion, sir, some members were anxious to know the action taken by the government on the recommendations of the Patents Inquiry Committee. I have just introduced a comprehensive patents bill which incorporates most of the important recommendations of the committee. Sir, the House would appreciate that it would take some time for the comprehensive bill, which involves a complete overhaul of the present legislation, perhaps, and may necessitate a motion for reference to a joint select committee to be passed by Parliament. In the meanwhile, it has become necessary for us to make an amendment to Section 23 of the Act for the purpose of vesting the controller of patents and designs with powers to grant compulsory licenses for the manufacture of insecticides, etc. Considering the vital part that agriculture plays in our economy, it is most important that the manufacture of these insecticides, etc., on a large scale should be encouraged, and that we should not allow any loophole in our legislation which can be exploited by the interested people. It is for this purpose, sir, that it is proposed to take powers to enable the controller to issue licenses for these articles exactly in the same manner as for food, medicines and surgical and curative devices. Sir, Clause 2 of the bill is intended to enlarge the scope of the existing Section 23 of the Indian Patents and Designs Act 2001 so as to include insecticides, germicides, etc., along with food and medicines. Clause 2 of the bill is intended to insert a new subsection, namely subsection 4, in the existing Section 23 to equip the government with the necessary powers by enabling them to notify the category of articles. The House will appreciate that it is impossible to draw up an exhaustive list of the articles for which it may be necessary for the controller to grant in future compulsory licenses so that articles are produced and made available to the public at lowest prices consistent with the patentee deriving a reasonable advantage from his rights under the patent. Sir, the amendment of which notice has been given by my senior colleague actually seeks only to clarify some ambiguities in the bill. As I pointed out last year, in some countries such as Japan and Germany, articles like food, medicines, and curative devices have been kept outside the scope of the patents law. We, sir, however, have no intention to prohibit the grant of patents to inventions in the field of food, medicines, insecticides, germicides, etc. Indeed, we want our scientists and technical men to play their part and to invent more and more in these fields. At the same time, sir, I hope that all sections of the House will agree with me that where patents for these articles are secured, it should not be allowed to be exploited to the detriment of the national interest. Stop.